Congratulations on beginning Unit 2. Since we have taken time in the previous unit to introduce ourselves to the Drupal module ecosystem and its various elements, such as Symfony, object-oriented programming, and the page call process, we can now focus our attention on the nature and structure of modules themselves. And we're going to do this by coding a module from scratch, developing and establishing our knowledge line by line. So I want to emphasize that it is important that you follow along and do the work I do on your own machine. Doing the work yourself is where the learning magic happens, and you'll transfer and convert the knowledge I share into your practical ability and skill. When I create a file, you should create the file. When I enter a line of code, you should enter that exact same line of code. Even if you have previous experience in Drupal module development, you will gain understanding by doing the activities. Along the way, as we try out the code on your local site, pay attention as I highlight valuable troubleshooting tips that you can use going forward. The module that we are going to build highlights the fundamentals, and so it is not complex in its nature. The module will alter a core Drupal node form and introduce us to the concept of hooks. Then, we'll build a custom page using a controller following the PSR4 standards, and we'll establish a route and path to that custom page. Finally, you'll understand how to create menu items by leveraging the menu API. The work that we do here in this unit sets the stage for the more complex module development we'll engage in with future units of this course. Remember, as you watch me code, you have the ability to pause the video or rewind if you need to. I encourage you to do that when needed. So without further ado, let's make it happen.